this week on Top Shelf Banter. Third word that best describes him.
A great smile.
All right, hold on. We're doing better. We're doing better. We're slowly bringing down to that one word that really describes him.
Now, grab a beverage, sit back, relax, and listen to an athlete, a booze hound, a guy with a classic ride, and three other guys talk about anything, everything, and nothing all at the same time. Everybody have their drink?
Yep.
Me too. Let's do this.
I've been thinking of some things I know just enough about that if someone shared their viewpoint, I could surely shut them down. So pour me a glass, I'll drink it down fast, and put your ignorance on blast on the Top Shelf Banter. Well, I'm more right than wrong.
Hello and welcome to Top Shelf Banter, where banter comes from the top shelf, our topics come from the middle shelf, and our research comes from the bottom shelf. We have a rotating topic master. I'm your host and your topic master, Jimmy.
Oh, fuck. If I'd have known that, I wouldn't have shown up.
You almost didn't.
Almost. And I have, I don't know if you guys could tell, I know the listeners can't, but everybody in the recording studio, I have officially tattooed my face in the colors of Italy's flag for them winning the Euro Cup.
He's a
congratulations,
big fan of Mussolini.
Italy, and now I am Italian.
That's all it takes, is a face tattoo?
Well, you have to, also the hand movements.
I did the hand
For the listening audience, he has his hands like you're going about to do an ohm, but then swing them wildly around in front of you.
Let's see if we can pick up when I'm moving my hands, okay?
Yeah. Everyone close your eyes and listen.
Mount St. Helens erupted. Mount to St. Helens erupted.
Oh, I can see the hands.
There it is.
Interesting. Immediately, it's just an audio.
It's like I'm in Venice.
Yeah, who knew there was an audio version of gesticulation? Mm-hmm.
Our other banter co-patriot, the man that deserves no introduction.
Zero accolades.
Donnie.
Hello.
I finally got your introduction correct this week.
Yes, it's been three months. Yeah.
First try.
Yeah. I do not have an Italian accent. I'll be using my own voice for probably the remainder of this podcast. We'll see, though.
I'm proud of you.
Yeah.
Our other banter co-patriot, the most stylish one in the sales to us all, Chapin.
Hello, hello.
Hi, Chapin.
It's a cool shirt.
Thanks. It's a velociraptor holding two beers.
That's a clever girl. Sorry. That was really obvious.
That's a good dad joke. That's a great dad joke. Even though you're not a dad, it's a good dad joke.
I could be your daddy.
Well,
listeners, write in. Do you want me to be your daddy?
Now it's getting weird.
Still my own voice, so it's okay.
Oh, it's getting weirder. And last but certainly not least, our final banter compatriot, the naked to us all, Derek.
Oh, hello.
You're making me so proud in that shirt.
Oh, am I?
Mm-hmm.
Well, okay.
It matches your watch.
Well, I definitely put the watch on because of the shirt.
See?
Swag. Yeah, hashtag swag.
Hashtag swag. Mm-hmm.
That's all it takes these days?
Yep.
Color coordinating two items?
Match two things on your body.
Sure. I got three because my shoes are technically blue as well.
Holy shit. There's so much swag on that side of the room.
Literally swag daddy.
He's taking it from all of us.
I put on my sweatpants, but otherwise my shorts would have also matched.
Hashtag stop the steal of my swag.
Mm-hmm. How about your thong? Is that matching?
Oh, I'm commando right now.
Oh, okay. Missed opportunity.
Is it still matching?
Yeah, my dick is blue.
Yep, boxers are blue.
It's not healthy. Should definitely go get that checked out.
Somebody get my dick some oxygen.
As always, we encourage you, the listener, to sit back, relax with a beverage of your choosing, alcoholic or not. Take a picture of what you're drinking and post it to social media using the hashtag Top Shelf Wednesday.
Oh, you mean hashtag Whiskey Wednesday.
Hashtag Swag Daddy Derek.
Yeah. Which, by the way, I completely missed hashtags on the last week.
Wow.
I know. When I went live and I made the post, is the rum episode. I completely missed the hashtag.
It's okay.
You
already let us down. We weren't expecting too much because you already let us down by not accepting the trade of the Subaru for the motorcycle. You were already low enough as
okay, it. Good. Well, I'm glad that I maintained that level.
And I wanted to save this to the end, but we might as well talk about it now. You're fired. After Michigan hashtags, thank you for coming to your firing. So please pack up your things, leave your booze and your headphones.
It was that
you
bad.
Are the was weakest microphone.
You got fired even before the ship was over? That's bad.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
The free labor?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Free podcast labor?
I mean, it's really, we're paying for that labor anyways. Like, it's never been free.
I'm there can only be one swag daddy, and that's me. Mm. So that's why I'm firing you.
I mean, I just figured.
I'm choosing not to give you the final rose.
I figured right now I could be the swag daddy since you've got the gun show, so.
Okay, oh. Fair. He's back on the show. That's all he had.
All right, but for less money. All it's right. A restructuring of your contract.
All right. All
right. And also, this is a
family show, so
family
bring
show.
Your kids.
Yeah. This is a call out to our listeners. Our next episode will be our 1 year of doing this. So,
there's got to be a word for that, right? Like a
anniversary?
Year-iversary?
Podversary?
Sure.
Podversary seems pretty good. So my urge, I guess, to our listeners.
Tell us about your urges.
Is to send us all of your questions that you want us to do, because that will be a very special podversary, because there won't just be one topic master. All four of us will be topic masters.
Ooh. So we're doing like a mailbag?
A mailbag.
A listeners on the loose?
It's going to be so much confusion.
Aren't the listeners the topic masters in that situation, though?
Yes, but we will be voicing their topics.
Oh, okay.
So if you have a topic that you want us to talk about, again, this is a little bit more special, so please send those in.
So everyone will be Spartacus at that point.
Yep. Everybody Correct. Will be the captain of the ship.
Oh, my God. There's so many Whoa. Captains.
So many captains. Wow. Literally, no ranks don't matter here. Oh
my God. So many chefs in the kitchen.
Are they going to be... Is it just going to be a touching of the bows?
Oh, we'll definitely dock ships.
Are coming in at one time?
There'll be a firm docking, that's for sure. Mm-hmm.
We don't want a dry dock, though. Get it wet.
Get it wet.
I'm sorry, listeners.
Speaking of wet, Donnie, what's in your glass?
Oh, just the wettest. I'm drinking some lovely San Juan Seltzer. This is a Rainier Cherry.
Nice.
Delicious. Mm.
Delish.
And then some water on the side.
Always good to see.
As a chaser, because sometimes the seltzer really gets to me.
it's
always
heavy
good to water
sometimes.
Down a hard seltzer.
Right.
With
well,
extra
sometimes
water.
It's just too much seltz.
Too much.
Ooh, yeah. So if you watered down a hard seltzer, would that make it like a medium seltzer?
No, it'd make it
a soft seltzer.
Yep.
Softened seltzer?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
A less hard seltzer?
I call it a room temp seltzer.
Depending on the
a
level of water.
A semi seltzer?
I like to cut my seltzer.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Extra ice, please.
Cut it with some water.
Put it on the rocks.
This heavily watered beverage is already too intense for me. I need to add more water to it.
If you could add rocks to that and put it in a microwave so it's all just mixed together so I don't see the rocks anymore.
I'm trying to get the flavor more of what LaCroix is on. So like a hint of whatever flavor that is.
Like hold that drink up and like pass it by a raspberry so I just get like, I get that
in
feeling
essence,
that it was near a raspberry
in
once.
Essence of raspberry.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
Chapin.
Yes.
What's in your glass?
Today I am drinking a Samuel Adams Boston Lager.
Ooh.
Mm.
How about that?
It's a classic.
There's an accent.
Oh, damn it.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it's a classic one.
Yep.
And I hope that it's not expired. It's been in my fridge for a while. Still tastes all right.
YOLO.
Yeah, it's probably good then.
Aged to perfection.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Derek.
Yes, sir.
What's in your glass?
Oh, tonight I am drinking High West Whiskey Double Rye blend of straight rye whiskeys.
Mm. Is that the one with the cool outline? The cool...
Yeah.
For the audience, there, Jimmy is holding up finger guns out to his sides.
Yes. Finger guns out to the sides.
Jimmy, remember, like we're not on video yet.
Because the logo is...
Like a saloon.
The logo is like a silhouette of a guy with a cowboy hat, like bursting through the double bar doors that swing with one hand on his hip.
Where do you think he was born?
Probably, I think it's Idaho. Is this in Idaho or is it Ohio? What is it?
No.
What do you think the saloon was called?
I don't know.
Swag Daddy.
Swag Daddy Saloon.
Swag Daddy Saloon.
The SDS. Come on down to SDS. Swag Daddy's drink free.
Utah. It's Utah, not Idaho.
That's ironic because I think Utah is just a dry county.
Hold on.
No one's ever been wet in Utah.
Right? It was distilled in a Utah. There it is.
No, it's more... I can't do a Mormon accent on the podcast. That's super bad.
Mine wasn't Mormon. It was Italian.
Oh.
Look at that.
Look at the hands going. I just can't stop.
It says right here on the back, we recommend trying a double rye, Manhattan, or old fashioned. It's also absolutely superb for sipping alone or sharing with other cowboys and good-looking strangers.
Woo!
Why do the strangers have to be good-looking?
Howdy!
I mean, I'm just drinking it alone tonight because I see neither of those in my company currently.
Yeah, because we're not strangers. We're your friends. Yeah. We're your
or
good-looking
cowboys
friends.
Or good-looking.
We're your bros.
Listen, cowboy is spirit only. You don't have to be a cowboy to be a cowboy, if I am understanding country songs correctly.
I've listened to Kid Rock. He's told me I'm a cowboy, baby.
Boy,
I actually do really wish.
Listen, as a man who's taking my horse down to Old Town Road,
I've also listened to that guy.
But I can't ride no more.
Yeah,
I'm a cowboy.
Yeah, took it down.
Mm-hmm.
Down an old dirt road.
I'm gonna have to make an old fashioned out of this one of these days. This is easily probably my favorite rye whiskey, and at like $35 a bottle, easily attainable, and you don't feel bad when it's empty because you can easily buy another one.
Yeah, it's pretty reasonably priced.
Exactly,
the price is reasonable.
Yep.
I was stopping the Italian accent from coming through when I was talking
unfortunately,
about whiskey. Italians, we don't drink a bourbon.
Well, luckily this is a rye.
We don't drink a rye.
Italians are not big on listening.
Apparently.
A lot of talking.
They're all about the Moscato.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
All about the Moscato. We don't drink a brown liquor.
So
it's all about the limoncello.
Papa Jimmy, what's in your glass?
Well, I'm drinking my delicious Rainier.
Oh.
And throwing it back to El Mayor Tequila Cristalino.
Oldest.
It's not a, I know it's not in, tequila is not an Italian beverage, but it works for me. And that's what counts.
That is what counts, Jimmy. That is what counts.
As long as it wets your whistle, that's the main thing.
Wets my whistle, and it always goes down smooth.
How wet is your whistle right now, scale of 1 to super wet?
I would say soup's wet.
Wow.
It's. I can't even put a scale on it.
Wow.
Put a number to it. It's outrageous. So, before we get into the topics, this is a story that I've been meaning to share with you guys. And I figured we could probably help this guy out.
Okay.
Okay. So, as we all know, my coworker, Nick, right? We've all met Nick. We all know Nick. His girlfriend's friend got into the online dating. We've all done online dating at one point in time. I figure
I dated before the internet, so I don't even know what that means.
Right? So, I figure the four of us can help this guy out because this guy reached out to the friend.
Right.
Okay. Nick's girlfriend's friend.
Right.
Right. So this guy reached out to her, and she was a little excited, and Nick sent me a bunch of screenshots of what the guy said. And I feel this guy, I think he needs a little bit of help with his online dating profile, and I think we can help him out.
I mean, we're all in successful relationships, okay? So I hope so.
So before, I'm going to show you guys a picture of what the guy looks like. Okay?
Okay.
He's got a great beard. He has got a great head of hair. I mean, he's a looker. He's got a decently sized head.
Mm-hmm,
you know,
mm-hmm.
He looks pretty normal.
Is that what you look for in a man? Yeah. A decently sized head?
He's got a good
that's
full beard.
Usually not the head I'm looking at, but yes.
He's got a good full beard. He's got a great, great look.
Mm-hmm.
Nice furrow to his eyebrows.
I mean,
he
can probably smile more.
Probably.
Yeah.
So
I'm a little frightened looking at him right now.
Sometimes people, it's better if they don't, like, have big smiles because, you know, then they might look like me. If I have a, you know, when I do my full smile,
right,
like, teeth exposed, kids start crying.
Well, yeah,
so
you act like you're going to eat a plate of ribs. Just smile a little bit. Don't dislodge your jaw.
All right, so, and to keep the guy anonymous, I have the guy's name right here, but I'm going to say that his name is Dylan.
Okay.
Just for reasons.
Well, first of all, can I give it my first piece of advice?
Yeah.
Aside from smile more. Change your name.
Change your name.
Get rid of Dylan. No one wants to date a Dylan.
Big D?
Dylan Pickles?
How about Chad? I've heard Chads are really cool.
Chad's pretty cool. Should we change his name to Chad then?
Yeah, sure.
I think we can get on board with helping out Chad.
Let's help Chad out.
All right. I'm going to read it phonetically as I can. And I want
Your Italian accent.
Without my Italian accent, and I want you guys to maybe know if I am portraying what this guy is saying. So, here's his bio. I, a very nice, caring guy, I hardly could lie, and I really don't like liar. I like camping, working on cars, fixing Elkitronic, cooking, and watch movies. I like little gambling sometime when I want to feel donate my money to the net of the land. Space, period. LOL. I am a 100% real guy. I don't play around lawful, but I have a bad luck in my life. I geese anyway. I am open-minded. You're more welcome to ask me freely anything, and I hope I got your answer. Space, period. Let's fold our teenage and maybe know each other as a grown-up. Space, period. Thanks.
I mean, that worked, right?
There's more.
Hold on. How old is Chad?
35.
Okay.
There's more. He's located in a town south of us. He's looking for a long-term relationship. He's 6 feet tall. He cook at self-employed with no E between the Y and the D.
Okay.
Employed.
I mean, that's just efficient.
He's he went to a university school. He has a college degree. He doesn't have kids. He smokes often. He drinks often. He shops other, and his languages are Arabic, English, and Italian. Okay.
Let me see where it says Italian, just so I know you're not lying to us.
It says right there.
It actually does.
It does say Italian.
That's insane.
So I'm going to guess.
There's more. I got more.
He's not native English speaker.
Maybe.
But you know what?
Well, considering listed Arabic first.
I don't understand, you know, how he still has an active profile. Like, this guy should have already been, like, had his choice of people to marry.
Choice of the pussy is what you're saying.
Yeah, I mean, I followed your guys' great.
You grossed yourself out.
I followed.
Would you say he's got a COP just waiting?
Ew.
Yeah.
I felt nasty saying that.
Wasn't great.
I followed your guys' great advice on the dating episode that we had. Like, what was that? Like, episode 3?
How to be a bad boy.
How to be a bad boy. Yeah. Bad boy.
Oh,
yeah.
And, oh, no, I think it was different.
Oh.
But either way, you followed it. Look at you. Now you're in a happy relationship.
So, I mean, if your guys' advice can land me a great person, a great woman, then...
You'll probably help out Chad, age 35. Question.
When you said choice of pussy, and it really disgusted you, I agree. Are you upset because it could have been alliterative and it could have been pick of the pussy?
Yep, P-O-P.
Yep. Get that pop. You got that pop, bro.
That's a little bit easier to pop. Yeah. But I still feel nasty.
And it pops.
Jake, this is not an invitation for you to say that word.
Oh, I was going to say, he probably enjoys that O-P-P.
No.
Oh.
All right, so here's other parts we could probably...
That's a throwback.
Spruce up his dating profile.
Yeah.
His favorite time of day, evening. Okay. Yep. Yep. Okay. I said that right. The best thing I can cook is, these are all just like, you know, questions and you fill in the blank. Okay. Best thing I can cook is filled up veggies, space period. Rost, checking, space period. All kind of sups. Yep. Sups.
Okay.
If I could live anywhere in the world for a year, I'd choose Turkey. No E. Left that out. Something I'm embarrassed to admit that I love is blonde women's. Is what he said. Yep.
Hold on. Let's all go around the table just real quick and list something we're embarrassed to love. Chapin, we'll start with you.
Britney Spears, Toxic.
Fantastic
song.
It's a great
song.
It's
funny you bring that up because I was going to say that needed to be the ASMR song that we did.
Baby, can't you see?
Derek, what's something that you're embarrassed to admit that you love is? We're all waiting on pins and needles for Derek.
Oh.
To say what he's most embarrassed about. Anxiously waiting.
You can say Chevrolet trucks.
It would be accurate.
I don't know.
When did Chevrolet start making trucks, Chapin? Well, just to follow
actually,
up
I
on
don't.
That.
Yeah, I've never seen a Chevrolet.
I don't. I mean,
large size Chevy cars.
I'm waiting.
That's actually honestly a tough question because I've never really like hidden anything that I enjoy. I don't like have like a secret like passion. I'm just an open
BTS.
Book,
you love BTS, the Korean
band.
Definitely a little the baby metal.
There you go. Oh.
I don't know. Maybe like the Pixar movies and stuff.
Okay. One thing
that's
I'm
not really like, I'm not really
critically acclaimed, highest grossing cartoons of all time.
Yeah.
Loved by adults everywhere. The Pixar movies.
Yeah.
One thing that I'm embarrassed
something later
to admit that I love is the Zoids TV show. Yeah. Come at me. It was really good. I enjoyed it. It was like Gundam, but in animals.
Oh, pretty cool. I don't remember that at all.
Yep. See? See? Y'all nerds. You guys don't know what I'm talking about. Get on my level. Donnie, what about you? What's something that you're embarrassed?
You guys.
Us?
You guys as a group.
All right. The Fair song enough. That always gets me on the dance floor is Hello, Good Moaning. Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Moaning.
Oh, the X-rated one.
And, no, he misspelled it. M-O-N. Good Moaning.
How do you spell moaning?
Like, I don't know. Good morning. I don't know how to spell. The three. Okay, here's one that I feel he missed on a little bit. The three words that best describe me are honest, humble. Please don't test me by crossing the line. I think he missed just a little bit.
That was all one word, right? Hyphenated.
Yep. The one movie I can watch over and over is Forrest Gump. Yep.
That's the story of, oh, God damn it.
What's take
Five or whatever. What is it? Take Five Gum?
Yeah.
Damn it. It's the story of Take Five Gum.
Orbits?
Yep. God, Orbits would have been a great choice, too. Damn it.
If I could eat three foods for the rest of my life, they'd be rice, chicken sup, and cucumber. Spelt with Q's.
Oh, sup means soup.
Yep.
I was so confused before.
Again, he's just being efficient.
Yep.
Remove exactly. Letters.
Yep.
And then a phrase that I often say is, be kind.
I was waiting for the rewind.
That was it.
Nope. Okay.
My idea of a perfect date is cuddling in bed, watch a movie, eat some steak, and play Guitar Hero, and good night, LOL. Pretty good.
Huh.
And that's it.
Okay.
So,
do I still make Guitar Hero?
I don't think so. I think he needs a little bit of work.
Okay.
So I'll just skip over the bio and we'll just go to, my favorite whatever and we'll fix it from there. Okay. Cause otherwise my very first thing that I would say could probably help him out being literate.
Right.
Or,
well,
there's
let's
spell
not
check
be too quick
everything.
To judge. This is a trilingual person.
Okay. All right.
That's tough to do. But, as a quadlingual person,
okay,
who is fluent in Spanish, and as we know, French from the previous episode,
yep,
and also Italian.
Yep.
And he even spoke Boston earlier.
Yep. I'm fluent in Bostonian. And,
that's the toughest language of them all.
And English.
And also English. So,
but
yeah.
But isn't the argument, though, is that the more languages you know, you should be able to spell correctly then?
Ooh.
As I'm doing my Donald Trump hands, as I'm...
Sometimes, but sometimes they all get jumbled up. I think there was an Adam Sandler movie about that called Spanglish.
Oh, Click.
Okay. Also that, where he really spoke electronics and English.
Deal. So, favorite time of day. Should we say, just leave it at evening, just correctly spelled for this guy?
It's not a bad time of day.
But is there a better time of day? Can we change his favorite?
Yes, we can. We're giving his bio a makeover.
Favorite time of day, 5:37 p.m.
Ooh, make it really
like
specific.
That's pretty good.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Shows that he's a man who knows what he likes.
That's yeah. Right.
What
that's
about 5:37 p.m. do you think he really likes? Is that when the sun starts its decline
in
the sky?
I'm going to guess that 5:37 p.m. is he's off of work. He's made it to the bar, and he's on his second drink of that first beer of the evening.
That's pretty good.
5:37 p.m.
Or 5:37 is when he starts to cook, because the next thing is the best thing I can cook is.
Mm. Well, you don't cook
he
beer. So
soup,
you could...
right?
So he filled, and that's spelled F-I-L-D. So I'm not, mm-hmm. I think I'm pronouncing that correctly. Filled up veggies, rost checking, and all kinds of sups. And
right.
By sups, he means soups.
Right. And so. I think by rost he means roast chicken?
Rost checking.
Oh,
I believe
checking.
He means roast chicken.
Well, Rost also has a checking account program, so it could be that he's cooking the books at Rost.
Oh, that's true. Maybe he does cook books.
Maybe this is an ad for illicit, laundering services.
Maybe.
Oh.
If that's the case, I think we should stop.
Yeah. I've seen Ozark. It doesn't end well for people who invest in it.
So, filled up veggies. What do you think he's trying to say there? What's filled up? Is that like stuffed
like
veggies?
Stuffed veggies, yeah. Like stuffed peppers, maybe? Mm.
Stuffed poblanos or whatnot? Okay.
It's not bad.
I mean, that's tasty. Yeah. So far, I'd love to share a meal with this man.
Yep.
Okay. He said Turkey is the place that he could choose to live for a year. Chapin, you lived in Turkey for 2 weeks.
Yes, lived extensively for 2 weeks.
Pretty good. Doable. Doable for a year.
Livable, yep.
Extrapolate 50 more weeks.
You cannot get away with only speaking English there, though.
Oh.
So it's good he is trilingual.
Good. Good, good, good.
A lot of Italian speakers in Turkey.
Right. Okay, he said the...
I mean, they're only two countries away, so there might be.
Absolutely true.
We answered the thing that he's embarrassed to love is, he said blonde women's, and by the way, there was no E on blonde, so it's blonde or whatever, however you would actually pronounce that.
I think it's like when there's an E, it's actually blondie.
Blondie. Okay, good, good, great. Glad to know I've been pronouncing it wrong this whole time.
Blondie woman.
The song that always gets me on the dance floor is Hello, Good Morning. Okay, I think we can change that up. Okay. What's a good song that gets us on the dance floor that we can then say this
Britney
is...
Spears Toxic.
No,
yes.
Sorry. Sum 41.
Oh, well, yeah.
Oh, yep. Yeah. That's always pretty good.
Yes.
Yeah. I was going to go Mambo number 5, but, you know.
Sure, a little Lubega.
I mean, it is a good song.
Yeah, it is a good
song.
What's
the other one you were begging your wife to have on the playlist? That's kind of like that.
Oh. Wasn't it Mambo?
Oh, man.
Cupid Shuffle?
No.
Oh, Papa Loves Mambo.
Papa Loves Mambo.
That's right. Papa Loves Mambo.
Yep.
And if the people, and if our listeners don't know what that is, oh, hold on, let me do a break.
Papa Loves Mambo.
Papa Loves Mambo.
Mama Loves Mambo.
Mama Loves Mambo.
Papa does great with it, swings like a gate with it, he loses weight with it now.
It was just in there. Cool.
You've been blessed.
Nice and easy. Oh. Hope everybody loves that, because that is my favorite song.
I hope that you're going to do a secret recording of you singing it to insert into that blank that
we
just had.
I could. The three words that best describe me are, you spelled honest correctly, so I feel we should keep that in there.
Well, he's honest about honesty.
Yep.
Because isn't that the key to getting around the copyright infringement, is if we sing it ourselves?
No.
I think even if you sing it could still technically...
Even if it's in the melody, how you get around it is you talk about the song and you critique it, because then it's fair use.
Well, we just did. It's Jimmy's...
Fantastic. It's a great, great song.
I disagree completely. It's the worst song I've ever heard.
Don't hate on Perry Cuomo like that.
I think it's a decent song to dance to on the dance floor.
Is it Cuomo? I thought it was Cuomo. Perry Cuomo?
Cuomo.
Isn't the governor of New York Cuomo?
He is.
Oh, it's Perry Cuomo. But it is.
Must be like his nephew.
All right, sure. So the three words that can best describe him are honest, humble, which you misspelled. I don't know if you guys got that through my enunciations. It's H-U-M-B-U-L. So I tried to catch that.
Humble.
And then the other one is the third word that best describes him is, please don't test me by crossing the line. And
that's
feel
the one I think we need to work on.
Yeah. well, first of all, we need to define where the line is. We don't even. He just says a line.
It's on
what
the ground.
Line?
It's on the ground.
Right,
that's where the line is.
But
it's in the sand.
I guess you're right.
The stop right. line at a four-way intersection. You can't go past that.
Oh, you got to really plan your dates out if you can't get around that line.
If there's anything I'm getting from this guy's profile is I think he's coming off as more of a lover than a fighter. So realistically, I feel that line is just like, hey, don't put hands on me.
It's
what I think he's trying to say. You know,
it's kind of a jagged.
Yeah.
Like, just
he's kind of going on the sticks and stones may break my bones, but words can never hurt me, you know. So, but if you put hands on him, then you know things might get a little.
So let's just change it to, "Don't put hands on me, bro."
Hyphenated, or should we just keep it at
what about,
that?
Don't start nothing, won't be nothing.
Yeah.
Oh, that could be a slogan.
Yeah.
That could be a phrase he often says. Don't start nothing, won't be nothing.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. Okay. So what's the third word? We'll use that. Boom. Slogan done. Phrase done.
Yep.
Third word that best describes him.
A great smile.
All right. Hold on. We're doing better. We're doing better. We're slowly bringing down to that one word that really describes him.
He's honest.
Yep.
He's humble. What's another H word?
Sup.
Horny?
Sup.
Yoked?
Sure.
Ooh, yoked?
I mean, big head, handsome. Big brains.
It's an H handsome. Word.
Handsome?
Yeah.
Honest, humble, and handsome. And actually, looking at this guy's pictures,
he's not bad looking.
He's a handsome dude.
He is a pretty handsome looking fella. Okay, one movie you can watch over and over again, Forrest Gump. Or what I think he meant to say was Forrest Gump. Mm-hmm.
That's an easy fix.
Just correct.
Don't say Tombstone.
Change the letter.
Don't that's say a Tombstone. Great movie, so.
Don't. Oh, okay. I thought you were going to say.
Forrest Gump is a phenomenal movie.
Okay, good. I'm glad I don't have
if
to
if there's
you.
Somebody that doesn't like Forrest Gump, then there
come
needs
see
to be.
Come see Derek.
Yeah.
Come put hands on Derek.
Yeah, see what happens.
See what happens. Yeah. Don't cross.
Derek's
line. Don't cross Derek's line.
I love Forrest Gump.
Is there a better movie for like date night, though, that you could maybe watch over and over?
51st Dates is always a good one. I feel like The Notebook is when you're...
Couples Retreat. One of my favorites.
I mean,
I hate Couples Retreat.
I think Up is a phenomenal date movie because as soon as you watch it, 5 minutes in, when they're going through all the memories and then the old lady...
Dies?
Has passed away, and it's all sad, and he's remembering.
What do you do on your dates?
No, just wait, because then you can get, you look at your date, and you go, I can't wait until I'm at that age, and I'm looking at pictures of you.
What date number are you on?
Oh, first date.
One?
Yeah.
There you go.
But also, that's still weird. I can't wait till we've been together so long that I have pictures, and also you're dead. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life after you.
Right.
Without you.
I can't wait until a fat little scout kid comes to my door.
Yeah.
I don't want him to be there.
I don't like grown women. I like fat little scouts.
Yeah. Since we're going along the Pixar route, can we just say Wall-E?
Sure.
Wall-E's a pretty... It's a good date movie.
Yeah.
It's a fun date movie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's fun.
Yep.
Everybody loves Wall-E.
Fun.
I'm still sticking with Up. I think that would... I think a lot of girls would be like, oh, that's so sweet.
No. No, not date one, Derek.
All right, Derek, start over. Start over. Start dating again. Find women. Do a study.
Sorry, Aaron.
I don't need to start over.
All right,
I found
three
a good one.
Three foods that he could eat for the rest of his life. He said rice, chicken soup, and cucumber, which I feel is a weird triage of
triad.
That's much
triangle.
Better than McDonald's. Burger King, like you list, like
Big
Mac.
Well, you got to put Wendy's first.
Of course.
Yeah. That's my point, Donnie.
I think just eliminate the cucumber and you're solid. Some chicken and rice.
Oh,
some
shrimp on there.
You got to keep cucumber in there or something green.
Yep.
So I'm
a cucumber salad.
There you go.
That's fine.
I don't know. Have you ever had cucumber water? Delish. Oh my god.
Three foods: cucumber water. That's
what you got there. Rice, chicken soup. Cucumber water.
I like to stay hydrated with the worst water you could possibly get.
No, it's so good.
Cucumber
it's good
water.
Good for you, too. Yeah.
When it tastes like a toilet bowl, cucumber water.
Oh.
Wow.
What do you think toilet bowls taste like?
Cucumbers. Because they're disgusting.
Derek throws cucumbers in his toilets.
That's where they belong, at a minimum.
And then watches them just flush down.
Well, that's how you test a toilet. You get a giant cucumber and you flush it down. Then you know you don't have to worry about plunging issues later. When you've had that night at the bar with a bunch of wings and you're like, okay, I know my toilet's up to it.
I should be shitting outside, but I'll use this toilet, I guess.
I'm going to test this. I'm going to test it first with this cucumber that I bought because I thought I was going to be healthy. Changed my mind.
I was very unhealthy.
All right, so idea of a perfect date or a perfect day.
Oh, a perfect day.
Okay. He said, and this is all, again, no punctuation through all this. And let's see if you can catch where I am reading his typos. Cuddling in the bed, watch a movie, eat some steak, and play Guitar Hero, and good night, LOL. I feel like cuddling in bed all day is not really a perfect day.
How are you eating that steak in bed?
Oh, and if you didn't catch it, he spelled steak like the wooden steak.
So he's eating wood.
He's eating wood.
So he's a
That's
beaver.
He's a beaver.
So his perfect day would then be building dams, not cuddling in bed.
Yep. And he not watch, well, hatch a movie.
Is that like a combination of watch and hatch?
Maybe. Maybe he is a... Oh,
Do
that's why he
egg?
Likes chicken soups. Chicken subs. Because he is a chicken. He lures him in.
He's a cannibal chicken?
He's a cannibal chicken.
No.
He lures in the unsuspecting hens.
Get into my hot tub that looks like a pot.
He slays them, cooks them, and then eats them. This guy's basically Hannibal Lecter in the making.
This is a serial killer.
This is a serial chicken murderer.
Mm-hmm. He needs to update that video game. That's bugging me the most.
Guitar Hero.
If Guitar Hero is that old and hasn't been updated.
Know you in one word.
Yeah.
Guitar Hero.
Something new.
Yeah. Definitely.
Can we suggest, like, Donnie will back me on this, Brave?
Sure. I mean, it's a great, real easy 1,000 gamer score. pretty interactive. A lot of frost spells or fire spells or lightning and wind too. There's like four elements.
Which one is strongest, or does it depend on which?
Oh, it depends on the enemy you're fighting.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. He has the advantage with Guitar Hero as being that is a game that he could enjoy with a date.
Okay.
And so it proves that his fingers are fast.
Yeah, if you're right? That's it. You got to key dexterous. Into that. He probably plays the bass like a boss. Just plucking them strings.
Yeah. I bet he can open a mailbox.
So,
like, nobody's business.
So now that we know that he plays, or now that we've said that he plays the bass guitar and he plays like a boss, should we change his name from Chad to Bob? Bob the bass boss? The triple B?
He's just... Hi, I'm...
What's up? What's up? I'm Bob, the bass boss.
So,
yep.
I think if you're going to put in a video game, you're targeting a specific female, or I should say significant other at that point, because it could go either way. And which is fine if you're targeting that specific person that also enjoys games. You're probably going to want a game that you can enjoy together if you're looking at it as like, oh, this is going to be a perfect day with my significant other. So
you're saying Destiny. You can raid together.
Yep.
You can do trials together.
Yeah, but you're not playing that on the same screen, so you wouldn't necessarily be in the same room.
Side-by-side screens, bro.
You could be in the same room.
Jimmy. I mean, that's super nerdy. You're going to explain a lot of that level of nerdiness in the bio, which there wasn't any of that in there. So...
Hypothetically, Jimmy, if you were single right now, would you put Destiny in your bio for online dating?
No. No, because I learned.
You'd wait to surprise her at home. Hey, yeah. Look at my vault.
Hey, if I was able to lead Amy astray about playing Magic for the first 3 months, I mean, and look at us now. We're married, and we are very happily in love, I guess. So
sounds like it.
So much confidence there.
Can we change it from Guitar Hero to Rock Band? Because then Rock Band is...
Is that newer?
No.
Well, I mean, either way, Rock Band, there's like a million songs, so there's bound to be a song that she likes. And I know that if there's one thing I know about women is they love karaoke. And they love to sing songs that they like.
Do they have Despacito on either one of those?
You know what? I would hope so. I would put money that Despacito is on Rock Band.
I'd have to buy it right now, Despacito...
I'm amazed we haven't started a Rock Band with just playing Despacito at bars.
I prefer not to.
But I think we should. I think we've now spoken it into existence. We have to.
We went through that phase like 10 years ago when somebody had Rock Band and we'd all play it. Mm-hmm. And I usually ended up singing the Metallica songs because my voice is just as boring as James Hetfield's.
Yeah. And I can't play the drums because they're not made for actual drummers. I went through like three of those drum sets because I'm just too swollen.
I was going to say, why would they expect you to be able to control those sticks?
Can't. Chabin looks like he's frantically Googling.
I'm trying to find to see if they had any updated Guitar Heroes, but
the last Guitar Hero was like Guitar Hero Live or whatever.
2015.
Yeah.
Yep.
6 years ago. Yeah.
All right. So I feel we helped out Dylan, or now Bob the Bass Boss.
Yep. Bob
the Bass Boss.
Bob the Bass
Boss. Sticks Guitar Hero.
Go and email us and tell us how your next date goes.
So we helped that guy out with his dating profile, and hopefully our advice will go pretty far with him.
It worked for Derek. It'll work for this guy.
That's right.
Yeah, I mean, I think that your guys' overall advice in our dating episode for me was overall a lot better. But
so we're gonna
thanks for that 5-star review, Derek.
Yeah, he's well. Hey, I mean, if
Yelp,
that
put
dating,
it on our Yelp.
That dating advice was able to get me someone as beautiful as Aaron. Then,
brownie points.
Wow, brownie points. The call out.
I want that cut out of the podcast.
I'll censor it.
Thank you.
If Aaron wants those kind of compliments, she's got to pay him. So
if their advice to give me something is blank, blank, blank is Aaron, well, I guess I'll try again.
Either Derek or Aaron needs to start paying to get those kind of compliments.
Yeah. Oh, is that how it goes?
Yep. Mm-hmm. So, to stay with my niches, because we all know that I love things on the internet and YouTube and other nonsense that I find.
Yes.
You are a 21st century digital boy.
Yep. So, this is a meme that I saw. Why can't we get a double hot dog? There's a double cheeseburger. What about a double hot dog?
There are places that do make double hot dogs.
Oh, really? Yeah. Which ones? Off the top of your head, go.
I think there's like a ballpark that offers one.
Oh, there's the hot dog stand right outside this Seahawks stadium that does a double hot dog.
I see where you're going with it, Derek. You're on thin ice.
whoa.
Thin ice.
Stadium then, okay. Thin ice. It may not be a baseball stadium.
Thin ice, Derek. Thin ice. I don't want you going, I know a ballpark. Speaking of baseballs, did you guys hear about the Laces? It's crazy.
Speaking of which, the Astros all withdrew from the All-Star game. Because they're fucking cheaters.
Good. Woo! That's the only baseball reference I'll allow from you.
Yep. That's a true statement that I did see today.
Good.
But no, I'm pretty sure that there have been double hot dogs before. I'm going to look it up right now.
I want to know why. If Jared can't find it, then it truly is. Then he lied. And I hate it forever. But why haven't there been double hot dogs around as long as there's been double cheeseburgers? Do you know I would kill for a double corn dog? Fuck.
Well, would it be?
I would kill for that.
Two hot dogs surrounded by the same coating.
Yeah.
Or two separate corn dogs with their own coatings melded together.
Well, it's like a fudgesicle.
Like you put like a Cool Whip or something in between to glue it.
glue
the corn dogs together with, I don't know, frosting.
Could you do like two different types of hot dogs? Like a spicy dog and like a regular dog?
What goes good with corn dogs? Cool Whip. Birthday cake frosting.
Mashed potatoes probably worse.
Get your sprinkles.
There you go. All right. So this was an article that popped up first thing. APnews.com from June 26. Anyone want to guess the year?
2018.
1969. Nice. Nice.
Oh,
1869.
69 BC.
Let's say that it's probably the birth year of somebody in this room.
Oh, 1947. Chapin, we're looking at you.
1742.
Yes.
How'd you know?
1776, America.
Oh. Yes. Because America's always in the room. No, 1988.
America's like Jesus.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. You're 88. You're 88, right?
Sure am.
That's what I was hoping. Otherwise, I would have been embarrassed of something that I like. Getting people's birthdays wrong.
Thank you, Derek. A little late, but close enough.
The double dog is just what the name implies. Two hot dogs on a single bun. The coney bun is cut twice with a divider of bread in the middle. Frankfurters are placed on both sides. People prefer the double dog because of the variety of dressings. So yes.
What are the variety of dressings?
I don't know. It
relish.
I didn't click all.
Mustard. Well, there's a thousand different types of mustard.
True.
Yes, that's true.
Mustard as a whole, though.
I was just at the Munkin house, and they have about... Actually, they have less because of COVID, and that made me sad. They're down to about, like, 12 options instead of, like, the 30 they used to have.
You put pickles and jalapenos on a dog?
You could.
Put chili on a dog?
Yeah.
Chili. Cheese. Grilled onions. Mm-hmm. Diced onions.
Okay.
Cream cheese.
Sauerkraut.
Cream fraiche.
Cumin.
Cream fraiche.
Turmeric.
If you're under the age of 18.
Geiger.
Cool Whip. Hot dog committee. Ketchup.
So now the real question is would you guys eat a double hot dog?
Yes.
So would I.
I'd eat it the same way I eat a normal hot dog. Completely plain.
What?
Nothing on it.
What?
Just an extra hot dog in there?
Sure. Oh, here we go.
Perfect.
My question is this, because we just had a world record breaking championship hot dog eating round from...
On July 4th.
Joey Chestnut.
Yeah, Joey Chestnut. Would he be able to eat, I think, 49 in whatever 10 minutes, or 78 million, or whatever he did? Would he be able to eat double hot dogs?
Like, would it be
Yeah.
Halved, or could he...
Right, could he reach those same heights with double the dog, half the bun?
We should talk to him for science purposes.
Oh, get him on the phone.
Well, I feel that I feel we, with our support, and of course the help of Jesu, I think he could reach any number of double hot dogs.
Is our support pre-chewing them for him and baby burning him?
I think he could surpass his single hot dog with doubles.
How much would you charge for a double hot dog?
At least a dollar more.
Because that's the normal hot dog for.
So I know. Are we talking like sporting event hot dogs? Are we talking like
let's
say
you're at the ballpark?
Or let's do this. Let's say there's a hot dog establishment in a city near us.
Okay.
Okay. Sure. They serve. I see Derek frantically waving his hand around.
Yes.
But you are not Italian, so do
breaking
not
news.
Do
no. Breaking there's news from no Derek. Talking.
Cultural appropriation.
So there is a website, barkhillfoods.com, that actually has, I don't know if it's something, there's not like a buy here.
I'm not
so
interested
not sure.
anymore. As soon as you said I don't
but
know.
It is a double French hot dog bun.
That doesn't mean anything to me. That looks weird.
Like it's built for two?
I don't like that.
It is built for two hot dogs.
Oh.
I don't like that.
I just call that a threesome.
It's like a loaf of bread that has two holes in it.
I know, right?
It's a hoagie that someone took a half-inch drill bit to it.
Yes.
Right, exactly.
I don't like
someone
that
get the Ryobi. Someone get the Ryobi. We gotta clear this out.
I like the better description of the one from 1988 better than that, but there is a company that apparently is making a double hot dog bun.
There's 30 pieces per carton, and there's 48 cartons per pallet.
Get a pallet of those?
You get 1,440 pieces per pallet.
Or you got to eat that up real quick, man. Or else it's going to spoil.
Well, you can freeze it for up to 365 days.
They have the shelf life is 365 days.
You have a freezer that that can hold a pallet worth of bread?
Who doesn't? And can anyone guess the country of origin? Derek, don't guess because I don't know if you saw it.
I saw that it said 116 grams, so that makes me think that it's outside of the continental U.S.
Measures in grams, too.
Not in hot dog buns.
No, they do.
It's ounces.
Grams is part of ounces.
Yep.
They measure in ounces. Here in America.
Ounces for
here
fluids.
In America.
For solids, we use grams.
In America, we measure in ounces.
Not when I get cocaine.
So what is it?
I've never said, give me 3 ounces of cocaine, please.
Yeah, you did.
Absolutely not.
America doesn't we weigh in ounces.
Freedom
we don't
minutes.
Weigh in grams.
Freedom
America
minutes.
Doesn't weigh in grams. That's ounces.
That's fluid ounces.
And also milliliters, right on the can. We also can put the metric stuff on food.
Yeah, don't measure in grams.
We
no
absolutely
says,
oh, do.
Oh, can I get help? How heavy is that bun? Oh, 86 grams. I like my
hot dog
bun.
No one's ever said, how heavy is that bun either?
I don't know. Depending on what country you're talking from, commie. I'm over here talking about America. We say, give me one of those buns and give me another one because I'm fat. And I lose all the droppings. And I like
because
to scoop it up.
I weigh 200 kilograms. Give me two buns, please.
No, that's not what we say in America. Oh. We say stones.
Say stones.
I weigh 3 furlongs.
I'm going to say outside of the U.S.
That's not a country, though.
Okay.
He called it a baguette, so I'm guessing France.
I'm going to say Canada.
I was going to give you a hint. It's in Ania.
Albania.
Oh, close. Close.
Very close.
Lithuania.
Oh, look at that. Took 2 guesses.
See? I called it outside the U.S.
Called it. Can you name one more Ania?
Tasmania.
Yeah!
I was going to say Estonia, but I guess that wouldn't necessarily be correct.
Well, all right. I guess,
I wonder if the hot dogs are like really big over there.
Maybe.
What if they eat them cold?
Ew.
And they're cold dogs.
Ew.
You never had a cold dog?
I used to like cold dogs
when
I was a kid.
Oh, my goodness. A cold dog is delicious. A cheese-filled cold dog?
Ew.
Oh, a CFCD?
You guys
never had one of those?
You guys are gross. I grew up in Bellevue where there was heat, so I never had a cold hot dog.
I left my cold dogs out in the sun, so the sun was a natural cook. Yeah, and you really could taste the...
Jesus.
The,
yeah. You could taste
no sun
Jesus.
In Alaska. It's 24 hours of darkness.
Oh, you caught me. I'm actually from the sunless land of Alaska.
I've seen that? 30 Days of
That's
Night.
That's right.
Yep. Where and our teeth break on the cold, frozen hot dogs. Because we call them hot dogs.
And
we
there's also we also know that there's definitely no sun in Alaska. We've all seen the maps. It's down by Florida. Mm-hmm. Come on now. It's all just fake sun.
Well, I mean, we've seen the maps, and it's down by Mexico.
Depends on what map and what time of year you're looking at.
What map are you looking at where it has it over by Florida?
I Googled it. Google's wrong.
Well, it is an island, and... You know,
yeah, well,
float around a little
they
bit.
Do float around. It's dangerous when we get all to one side exactly. for our festivals. It almost flips.
It meanders.
Yeah. It's a meandering continent-sized island.
All right. So my next one is, do we want to get Donnie angry or do we want to just...
Okay.
I have a feeling... Actually, we'll go fun. How about this?
I'm going to get angry just for fun.
So this one is you have to choose a superhero mask, and I have a list of 9 masks.
Okay.
And we're going to choose it, and then we're going to critique each other on which on if we think their mask that they chose is correct.
Okay.
Okay. Once it, I know I worded
it.
I hope
it makes sense in a minute.
I know I worded it weirdly, but
right now you're wrong.
It'll make sense. Okay. The 9 masks. Green Ranger Power Mask. The mask from the film series The Mask. Iron Man. Black Panther.
Is Iron Man's a mask or a helmet?
It says helmet. Okay. It's a helmet, but it's okay. It's a choose a mask to wear and you gain the abilities, whatever. So it's wrong. I got it off of Facebook. Who cares? Jason. Jason's mask, the hockey mask. Mm-hmm. Batman.
Okay.
Magneto. This is most likely any one of the feds. So I'll leave it up to you. Or the Wolverine.
You gain the powers.
You gain the powers. You become that person.
Okay.
Donnie, what's your choice?
How are we judging this?
We're just going to... How we normally judge each other.
Oh, okay. Well...
How we normally judge each other.
Then Iron Man.
Gay. That's dumb. That's a fine. Dumb choice.
I'm sorry. Imagine me picking pussy in the Iron Man mask.
God
You brought that on yourself.
Ew.
Brought that on yourself.
It's nasty. Chapin?
The mask.
The mask? I figured you would do that. That kind of fits, you know?
Great choice.
No judgment.
I'm not going to lie, that was
That's
the one
against
that
the rules of
hate.
The game. You have to judge him.
I'm judging it by hating it, how good a choice it was.
Oh, yeah. The mask would be a great one.
You could change your face to any different... It's always green, but it could be super handsome, super ugly.
Mm-hmm.
Cut to your confidence.
And technically, isn't it like the mask of Loki or something like that?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
Tricks.
Careful, careful about talking about Loki. Disney's copyrighted that Norse myth, so they own Loki now. So.
TM.
Watch
Dirk,
out.
What mask are you choosing?
I'm sorry, Derek, that Norse god.
No, I know, but the copyright that, like, is, yeah, it's you could still explain about the Norse god because you can't copyright.
Disney owns him now.
They own the likeness of the spelling of the way they spell it and
I'm
the
not,
Marvel
I'm
character.
I'm not a lawyer, Derek. You can tell me on that.
Don't trust me. I've read a couple articles on it. There, you can still talk about the Norse god Loki because guess what? You can't copyright something that's thousands of years old.
I bet you I can.
Disney just did it.
Yeah.
Water's being copyrighted.
Yeah. Right. What is? Thanks, Nestle.
All right, Derek, what's your mask?
What were the masks again?
Green Ranger, Power Ranger.
Yep.
The mask.
The one that I wanted and it was taken before.
Taken from you.
Yep.
Iron Man.
Hold on. I see a mask right there in the top middle you didn't name. But that's not fair.
I said Jason. I said Jason's mask.
Oh, excuse me. It looks like the Saw doll mask thingy. So excuse me. My apologies.
Jigsaw?
I sit corrected and embarrassed. I need glasses.
Sassy. So the Black Panther.
Okay.
Jason. Batman. Magneto. Any of the Fets. This based off of where I got this meme from.
So a Mandalorian.
It's probably Mandalorian, but I'll leave it open. You can do Jango Fett, Boba Fett.
Name one more Fett.
This Mandalorian
Fettuccine
Fett.
Alfredo.
Fettuccine.
I would probably
go. Or Wolverine. Wolverine.
Fett.
Ooh, Wolverine's solid, too.
Oh, I want an Alfredo Fett spinoff.
I'm here for the baby Yoda. Hand him to me right now.
Are Jawas?
You do
Jawas
speak Italian.
Are Jawas technically Italian? Because every time you see them yelling, they're constantly moving their hands up and down. Are Jawas Italian?
I mean, it's probably why you can't understand them.
It's another accent. Donnie just said another accent.
Josh, I didn't know you could speak Jawa. I'm so proud of you.
That's way too nerdy for me. I've never learned to speak Jawa. Klingon only, please.
How about Elven? Do you know Elven?
Sure. Lothlorien? Galadriel? I don't know. I hate dwarves.
Perfect. That's all you need to know. And you can speak that in common.
You did it. Hey, Gimli. Glad to see you. You can't play Gimli. You don't have a beard. Get out of here.
I'm a barefaced elf.
You're a barefaced bitch. I went there.
Elves are normally
that's why I need a mask.
Barefaced.
Oh.
I know. Sorry. He hates people who are barefaced. Because I can't grow a beard. Because I'm a poor, poor elf.
Yes.
Poor, poor elf that's really good at archery and wears really elegant stuff.
And I can slide down stairs on a shield.
But it's okay because you're going to die next to a friend.
Yep.
Well, yeah. Right.
That's right.
Thanks for bringing it down, Derek, and back to death.
Well, I was just
Derek, what's your mask?
Like the super like popular meme that, you know, has that interaction. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Anyways, I'd probably go with Jason Voorhees because he doesn't die.
Live forever.
Yeah.
All you have to kill him is a cup of water. And here's some water, Jason.
And then he comes back for the next episode, for the next movie. He doesn't die.
And next episode, hold up, smoke weed every day.
That's right.
So Derek's telling us that we can only temporarily get rid of him.
That's it. I'm going to come back.
No.
Where's Chapin? You can be anything we want. You can be that for us.
Yes.
Derek says, no matter what I am, I'll come back.
Chapin, you can be our hero, baby.
I could. I'd also be Derek.
Chapin, can you kiss away the pain?
I don't know the next line.
All right, so Derek, I don't
stand
agree
by me forever.
With this Jason mask for you.
Will you take my breath away?
I feel like you're more of a Magneto kind of guy.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Just I thought about you, Magneto. That'd
just
because
you love Germany for some reason for being a French guy.
So
you love Germany.
Doesn't Magneto hate Germany?
No, he is German.
No,
or no.
No,
he's
parents went to the camps.
Yeah, he is German, but he hates. He hates Nazis because
he hates humans. He just hates humans.
Yeah, so
because we're weak.
So you're giving me an evil guy's mask, but like not as cool of an evil guy. I mean, Jason.
What's wrong with Magneto?
Think about what Jason actually does. Jason purifies the world of sinners.
He just kills. Oh.
Is Jason Jesus?
He might be. Like, he's like, oh, you just had sex and you're not married.
Is
Jason
Jesu?
Is Jason Jesu?
I mean, they have basically the same amount of letters.
Almost.
And they're spelled exactly the same.
There's five letters in Jesus.
Okay. Now, in Jason, how many are there?
So five letters. There's a J and an S in the correct spot, in the same spot.
Jesus, when he came back, definitely started preaching with a machete.
Yeah. And phonetically, the A is an upside down E, which is basically Jesus. So.
You heard it here first, folks.
Jason is Jesus.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Jason's mother also plays pretty heavily in the mythology of Jason, just like Jesus' mom.
Teresa.
Yep. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Teresa. So the last
or
three.
Or Mary.
There you go. There you go.
We've lost the last three.
You're confusing
three,
your mothers.
The last three listeners are now gone.
Well, if I were to choose a mask, I'd choose the green Power Ranger mask. Just because I want that flute and the dragon sword.
Yeah, you do.
There you go.
Yep. Dragon sword.
So then who wins in the fight?
Between the four of us?
Iron Man, Jason, who drowns, obviously, right away.
But comes back.
Dragon zorded green ranger.
Yep.
And the mask.
Well, I think technically the mask is unkillable unless he actually takes the mask off.
I can't remember how that movie ended. Because when the bad guy gets the mask, what they defeated him.
Yeah.
By taking his mask off.
Was that it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then he got arrested.
Mm.
So
as all villains do, kids. Let that be a lesson.
Let that be a lesson.
That's true. He does turn into like a Gumby, kind of like a
stretchy. Can't be shot.
Yep.
And he ate dynamite.
That's true.
So realistically, Iron Man is out.
Well, no. I just have a bunch of little gloves that come around, distract you, and then one hand comes in, steals your face. Boom.
Oh, that's right, because you probably have some kind of weird technology that's specifically about taking masks off.
I always have specific technology. I call that Protocol 74312.
Protocol Niche?
Yep, exactly right.
You need to censor that because that can't be public.
That is proprietary information. Government paid for and operated, so I'm sorry.
All right, I will get that in post.
I mean, to be honest, the mask is going to be the most fun to hang out.
Yeah.
And let's be real. If Chapin had a mask, he would be a super fun mask.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But, I mean, as a trillionaire, playboy.
Billionaire.
I made some wise investments between two movies.
Oh, like Dogecoin.
Yes. Exactly. Nice. I invested heavily in Dogecoin.
Nice.
Put $3 billion into it, and now I'm a quadrillionaire.
Wow. Fantastic.
Yep.
There's not enough money to pay me for my Dogecoin. So.
You're just paying Doge.
Yeah. And the Green Ranger can give us super cool rides and play us music.
Yeah.
It's true.
So, stalemate.
I think it's just...
Well, as long as the three of us win, and Derek's just in the lake.
Derek's in the lake. That works. All right, we'll go.
Just going to end up killing you guys because you guys are sinners.
We'll go a final one. So
no,
this...
I marry all the people I fuck.
We'll go with a final one, and this one could be pretty fun with Donnie. So we all know we all know my favorite, if an animal were to wear this, how would it wear it?
I didn't realize you'd only had one partner in your life.
Mm-hmm. Virgin!
So this one is about Alien, specifically from the movies Aliens.
Like the Queen Alien?
Queen Alien.
Okay.
So, if the Queen Alien were to wear a hat, like a regular baseball hat, Derek, don't get too carried away with this, just because I mentioned baseball. If it were to wear a baseball cap...
Fuck the Astros.
Okay, I'm okay with that. Touche. Yeah. How would it wear it? So, there's 9 options here. 1, regular on the front part of the head. Number
like
2...
Balance it there like a like T.I.?
Yeah, like where its forehead would be, because you know how it's like... straight flat back, right? So, number 2, this one is a little caveat to it, but I'll allow it. 3 hats, one in the front, one in the middle, one in the back. Number 3.
That's been an expensive hat.
Number 3, on the very back part of the head, not fully flat, just a slight angle to it, brim up.
Yep.
Number 4, a giant hat, bigger on the same side, but only covers half the head, same angle. Number 5, a hat that covers the entirety of the head.
Like an Elmer Fudd hat?
Like an Elmer Fudd head hat. Number 6, on the back half of the head, literally that bulbous, sticking straight up, and a hat on its tongue. Number 7, a hat in the middle of its head, also with a smaller hat on its tongue. Number 8, got rid of the hat completely, visor, halfway down the hole, the head. Or number 9, going back to the medium-sized hat that's on the forehead that goes back to the halfway through the head.
You see a picture real quick?
I know. I just Google searched a picture of the Queen Alien.
Here.
All right.
I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this. I'm going to save you guys the trouble from Googling it. I'm just going to send it to you guys.
That's too late.
This is fantastic podcasting because I'm sending it to
bottom shelf research.
Podcasting a real visual medium. Let's keep going.
We'll put it out. Derek, you're going to be in charge of putting it on.
Oh,
hold on.
I just found a double hot dog on a website that's just terrible, so I'm not going to link it. This is just a hot dog bun, okay, with a hot dog on one side, a quarter slice of bread long ways in the middle, like a Big Mac bun.
Ooh, fancy.
Yeah, I think that's how the
upsets me.
The guy from 1988.
I don't know what you're talking about, Derek. I don't recognize that year.
The article that I mentioned, I think that's what he was talking about.
I don't recognize that year.
Okay.
That picture is obviously taken post-1988. There's way too many pixels in it.
All right, so the picture I just sent you guys of the alien wearing a hat.
Yeah. Derek, what do you think?
Which way is the alien wear its hat?
I'm going to go with that it is probably going to be like kind of on like the top of the head, like normal. So it's going to be like on the brow, facing forward, brim out, and then the little head coming out of the mouth is also going to have a tiny.
So is that number 7 or 6?
I don't remember your numbers and explanations.
They're right there. You're looking at the same picture.
I sent you it.
Oh, I didn't realize that. Okay.
Hey, Derek, do you remember when I said I sent you guys
the picture? I thought you were sending us a picture of the Queen Alien. That's why I was like, no, I don't care about that. I just Google searched it. I have a picture of the Queen Alien.
And it's a Queen Alien, please.
Chapin, while Derek's looking at it.
Oh, three of them. Oh, I like number five with the giant.
That's what I was thinking. Five, so the giant long hat that covers the entirety of the head.
Yeah.
That one looks the best. That's a swag daddy alien right there.
Right? I'm going, I would go 9 and 6. So take away the back of the head on 6. Give it 9, and then the little guy has his own hat too.
He's doing a combo.
Yeah, so we're gonna
squeeze the visor in there somehow.
Yeah, we're gonna call that the 69.
Nice,
right.
Nice. Donnie, what do you think?
I mean, that's with any of these arguments of animals wearing clothes. You have to think about the original purpose of the clothing item. And okay. Hat was primarily three reasons. One, to block the sun from your eyes.
Two,
hide a bald spot.
Three, maintain.
And to really support your cool local sports team.
Okay. Yeah. I thought it was to keep body heat from escaping. Oh, but that's okay.
Four
that's
reasons. If you're in the wintertime, wear a baseball hat. You will not get hypothermia.
Deal.
That's guaranteed.
Not Deal. A trucker cap.
No.
Not going to do anything.
Too much
for
heat
you.
Is lost through those yep. little vents.
That's right.
Yeah. You need a fitted cap.
Mm-hmm. So
no snapbacks.
So that's just based it. Off of your explanation, Donnie, I'm going to guess three. Is that what you were going with? Three?
Yeah. It's the crown of the head.
The very back.
Yep. I mean,
the main bald spot.
It doesn't matter how long and tall your head is. That goes right there on the top, and that's where that hat is. And we all know that the Queen Alien does not have eyes. So if they're going to wear a hat, it's going to be for show, not functionality.
True.
And you know what? When you lose heat from the head, it's the top of the head. You don't need it on your forehead. You need it from the top. So number three there. That's key. And if you're really cold, number two.
I like 8. Even though it's a visor, I know it's not a hat, but I feel like it's a pretty bro move, that alien to wear a visor.
It would look a lot better if the visor was just a little bit bigger, so it just fall down just a little
just
bit.
Just a little
further.
Bit to the nook of its neck.
And let's be real, it should be like backwards and to the side, or upside down.
Upside down?
To the side.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
So this is just a Chad alien, but if he was to do that, be a Chet or Chaz. Mm-hmm.
Definitely.
That's true. Chaz, I agree.
The evolution of Chad.
So what? So what's our agreement then? Are we agreeing
on
a combo
you just
6-9?
A Chaz. Sure.
A combo 6-9, 3 hats. Yeah.
Tongue needs a hat.
Tongue always needs a hat.
Tongue does need a hat. If that tongue gets sunburned, you're not going to be eating people with that tongue.
No, you're not.
No.
Mm-mm.
Does the tongue have eyes?
Who's... The hills have eyes, but not the tongue.
Okay.
Who's going to put aloe on that sunburned tongue? Nobody.
Nobody.
They're going to be so scared. Because, one, it's acid.
And it's got teeth.
Yeah.
Tons of teeth.
You're going to melt.
Do you think that's how the queen actually eats her victims? Like, oh no, my tongue is sunburnt. Can you just come over here and put some of this...
A Venus flytrap alien?
Aloe vera on it? Yeah. And then out of nowhere, ka-cha!
Mm-hmm. Gotcha, bitch.
Eats it.
Yeah. I think it does.
And that's how its babies are made.
That's exactly true.
Sustenance.
And that's how regular babies are made, kids. Yep. I know you're listening from the beginning.
All right.
When mommy eats daddy with her tongue, that's how babies are made.
That's how babies are made. Your mom is the creature in Aliens.
That's right.
She's the queen.
It's all over, man.
Deep down inside.
Call her queen. She'll love it. She'll love it. All right. Should we bring it home?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. As always, we would like to thank our friend, Mr. Jordan Mosley, for creating the music for our podcast. If you're interested in more of his music, you can find him on iTunes or Spotify or wherever you get your music from. SoundCloud, wherever. Napster, LimeWire.
Sam Goodies.
LimeWire.
FYE.
Preferably not LimeWire. We want you to continue having an operational computer so you can continue listening to this podcast.
Bear Cuddle, right? Cuddle Bear? Yeah. Is that what it was?
Yeah. Emule.
Bear Share.
Yeah, Bear Share.
Or to go opposite of what Derek said, use LimeWire, burn your computer, go buy a new one, and help buff the economy out.
And if you need help with buying a new one, visit us on topshelfbanter.com/personalcomputers.
Yeah.
Yep. .org.
There'll be an affiliate link there. And,
we got a side hustle I didn't know about.
We all split the cost.
I mean, hey, if there's somebody you need to buy a computer, Donnie's the guy. He snagged me a laptop at the pawn shop, super cheap.
Don Don the Computer Mon.
That's right.
Yep.
You've seen my business card.
I didn't know that was you.
So, Chapin, let's say I'm a listener and I want to hear us discuss some of the topics that I'm interested in as a listener. What are some ways for me to get in touch with us?
Topshelfbanterpod@gmail.com. That's it.
Only one.
That's all that matters. Mm-hmm.
You can get a snippet on YouTube.
Yep.
And we got a Twitter. We got an Instagram. Pretty much just search topshelfbanterpod at gmail.com.
You want to see some sweet, sweet nips? Find us on OnlyFans. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. Sweet.
Mm-hmm.
Join the one-sided conversation on Facebook. One-sided because it's only us that post the podcast.
But as always, this is another push to our listeners. If you have questions for our podversary, send them out.
Yeah.
Email, Twitter.
Good spot for them.
We're on everything.
Send a DM or whatever on Facebook.
Slide into our DMs.
Slide into Donnie's DMs.
Hard into those DMs. Mm,
like you're sliding into second, right? Am I right, Derek?
That's right. Cleats up.
Juicy turd.
Cleats up.
Diarrhea. Oh, did I miss it? Were we not supposed to sing that
well, that's
childish
when you're sliding, that's when you're sliding into third.
Oh.
Yeah.
I forget what second one is. I don't want to talk about that anymore.
I think it's I'm sorry with
for
diarrhea.
I'm still bringing it up. I'm sorry for bringing it up.
That was on you.
That was on me. I got excited at the chance to do that childhood nursery rhyme. And I got excited and a little carried away. And I apologize for that.
Apology accepted.
Thank you. Hold on, wait. I apologize for that.
Even more accepted.
Yes. Or anywho, that's Derek.
That's Donnie.
As always, that's Chapin.
That's Donnie.
No, that's Chapin again.
That's Derek.
That's Donnie.
Oh, and this is Donnie. Oh, hold on. And that's Jimmy.
We hope you have enjoyed the frustrations behind our opinions on these topics. Thank you for listening to Top Shelf Banter. And
we done.
Top Shelf Banter. Well, I'm more right than wrong.